Hey guys, I'm here with Emily. End of the girls' volleyball game, Downey versus Warren. Emily, how are you feeling about this game?
I feel amazing. We did so well. We kind of started off really slow in the first game, but we came back and we proved that we deserve to win.
Hey guys, I'm here with Michaela. How'd you feel about like towards the end of the game? Did you feel like you guys weren't gonna make it, or did you have that confidence like we're gonna win this game tonight?
I was confident. The crowd helped us a lot, and we had a lot of momentum. It was so exciting.
And how was the end of the game? Because the ending was really like nerve-wracking for everyone in this gym. So how can you explain how it happened?
It was just exciting. We knew we were going to do our thing. Our emotions, we kept our emotions together, and we did really good. We got through it as a team. I'm really proud of everyone.
The biggest game of the year, and to win like that, it's just, it's so awesome.
Hey guys, I'm here with Mr. Amardaris. How did you feel about today's game?
It was awesome. So exciting. And we won, so that's great.
We did. Hey guys, I'm here with Mr. Houts. How did you feel about today's game?
It's exciting. We got a roll over Warren right now.
How was the ending of the game? Because it kept a lot of us at the edge of our seats.
She's a stud. I think she must have scored most of the points tonight, but that's a good way to end it.
Hey Vikes, I'm here with Coach Sims, girls volleyball coach. How'd you feel about today's game?
I was, quite honestly, extremely nervous. With all the emotion going in today, I didn't know what was going to end up happening on our side of the court. So definitely nerves played with the outcome.
And towards the end of the game, it kept everyone at the edge of our seats. Can you explain why? And
no matter what, it's always going to be the crosstown rivalry. It's going to be the awesome Downey Warren spirit that we have here in Downey Unified. And that's what makes us so special about going to Downey and going to Warren. That's what makes us Vikes. We keep fighting until the end. Our crowd was amazing. And I really do believe that they were our seventh player on the court. They willed us to win. You willed us to win.
Exactly. So what does this event mean to you, Volley for the Cure event, to raise money for breast cancer?
I wanted to start this last year when, actually 2 years ago, things got a little bit out of control and it was more of like a hated rivalry. I knew that the community of Downey was better than that, and I knew that we could end up coming together. So I wanted the passion, instead of hated passion, to be used for something better. I saw it online and it said pack the place pink. There was something that I saw and I thought, that's what we're gonna do. Downey and Warren, we're gonna come together, and ever since then, we've pushed forward with it.
That's amazing, that's really great. How are you connected to breast cancer personally? Do you know anyone, your family, neighbors, friends?
Mr. Rand actually had the girls volleyball team. He told me about the Susan G. Komen walk in Orange County. In Orange County, and we've been doing that for about 5 years. But just going and doing the walk, not really much other than that. Last year when we started doing this, I realized how many people I knew. It's kind of one of those things, breast cancer, where it's very hush-hush. Mm-hmm. And women don't want to talk about it. And so you don't know how many women are affected by it in your circle of friends. I have found out a very dear friend of mine, one of our past counselors, she has it. One of our English teachers in the department, she has it, had it, excuse me. My sister-in-law's mother just had surgery June. Found out in May that she had breast cancer and had to have surgery immediately in June. And it's just one of those where, again, it's kind of hush-hush and you realize like, wow, you're so thankful to be healthy and not going through this, that we need to celebrate life and those who have fought the battle.
Yes. What was your goal for today? How much money did you plan on?
Our goal is $10,000. And the reason why we did that is last year we set the goal at $5,000 and we're able to up it to $7,000.
Did you make your goal last year?
We went past it by about $2,000. Awesome. This year I was hoping that I would rather aim high and miss than aim low and hit. And that's why we went for $10,000 this year, because no matter what, every penny counts.
Yes, it does. And how do you feel about this event, raising money for breast cancer?
I think it's so great. I mean, it runs in my family, breast cancer, so this is kind of a personal thing as well. And I just am glad to be a part of it.
So what does this event mean to you? The Dig Pink Volley for a Cure event?
My grandma passed away of cancer when she was pretty young, so I think it means a lot to kind of help out to at least find a cure for cancer. So It means a lot.
And how do you feel about this event of raising money for breast cancer?
Oh, it's good. It's good. We all the ticket proceeds go to the Side Out Foundation. So we didn't make as much money. We didn't make any money today, but it's a good cause. So we're down for it.
So what did you do to what did you guys sell here and to raise money, raise funds for this event?
We did the t-shirts. Everybody was so wonderful. So the t-shirts, hopefully when those get all sold, and we're still gonna keep trying to sell those, hopefully that'll bring in 4,000. We had baskets, families donated, teams donated, companies donated. We had raffles, we had the snack bar. Excuse me, we had the snack bar. Clubs were helping out, Future Teachers of America. We had Miss Story's class was helping out. Norma Nears was awesome. I can't even name all the people that have been helping out. I mean, that's just a few behind the scenes, and everybody was so amazing. Student Council came out. I mean, it was pretty,
it's pretty humbling
to see how many people are ready and willing to support something like this.
That's really amazing. So when can we find out how much we raised today?
We actually just took the money to the vault, or Ms. Foley did, and so we're gonna start counting tomorrow.
Okay, sounds good.
So hopefully by the end of the week, if not by tomorrow, because I'm very anxious too.
Yes, I
am. So we'll see, and we're still gonna keep trying. Even if we don't hit the 10,000, we're gonna keep trying to,
of course,
to pull it in and
see
what
happens.
We're
never gonna quit to raise money for breast cancer.
Absolutely.
We had a great game today. It was amazing.
Thank
you so much, Ms. Sims, for talking to us.
You guys are awesome.
You are awesome.
Go Bye.
Thank you. Everywhere I'm looking.